Pilgrim is a 32-foot sailing boat, and she's about to have a complete overhaul of her navigation and electrics.
This is quite a complicated system. The Raymarine side alone is quite complex, with new radar, sailing instruments, and the Axiom multifunction display.
The first job Chris needs to do is update the Raymarine to the latest firmware. After providing power to the Axiom and the initial setup was completed, Chris selected Settings Update Software. This device has Wi-Fi built in, so he selected Check Online, connected to his local network and started the update. The download does take a while, but the Victron Management app is included in the Raymarine firmware bundle version 3.11.42 that was released in November 2019. Once complete, the new Victron app is installed.
Previously, you would have had to spend a lot of money and a lot of time programming up a master control unit to make this work. So this integration is a much more cost-effective way of the Raymarine and Victron talking to each other. The original power source was just lead acid batteries, which were failing and had failed in the past. He's taken the view that he should move to lithium. Lithium is going to give him much, much more usable power. It's going to give him a more constant power supply. It's just going to be absolutely brilliant for him. The heart of the system, which we've put in, is the Venus unit, which talks to the Raymarine unit, which is a great advantage. It also has a lot of advantages from our point of view, in that we can control some ancillary equipment, which you'll see later on is quite important. The other part of the system is the Victron Multiplus, the 1600 watt 12 volt compact unit, which is going to give him all the AC power he wants on board.
There will be six areas of the boat that require significant electrical changes and connections. The installation of the lithium batteries, the cupboard containing the Victron Multiplus and the majority of the Victron equipment, the lead acid engine starter battery, the lead acid bow thruster battery, the stern where there will be new Raymarine equipment including the new panel, and the internal chart and navigation table area.
Battery temperature is down to 1 degree, despite the fact the temperature here is 7 degrees, so we now need to try solve the problem of how to heat the batteries up on a boat in Cumbria. Below 5 degrees C, we can't charge lithium batteries. The battery management system will switch it off and it'll stop it happening. So we need to solve this problem. We need to use any available energy to warm the batteries up before we start charging the batteries.
This 12 volt, 30 watt pad will be sandwiched between four aluminium sheets to distribute the heat. It'll sit at the bottom of the lithium battery box, keeping the area warm. This thermal image of the battery shows how a small amount of heat below the battery slowly heats the battery's dense contents, bringing it out of any low temperature alarm. Chris is installing a PT100 resistance thermometer between the two batteries and wiring it to one of the tank inputs on the Venus GX.
The Venus device is a little device produced by Victron that will talk to the outside world via the VRM portal. Brilliant if you want to see what's happening with your boat remotely. Or in this case, what we're doing is we're sort of thinking out the box a bit and we're actually using it to control the heated pads underneath the lithium batteries.
After going to Settings, Relay within the Venus GX and changing the option to Tank Pump, Chris was able to keep everything within the Victron system and engage the tank pump relay to operate in relation to the PT100's resistance. The Venus GX relay then engages a larger relay more suitable for switching the heat pad on and off automatically.
We can then use any excess power source that's available, the alternator from the engine or the battery charger, to power this heater, which will bring the batteries up to 5 degrees C. At which point it will then switch over and start to charge the battery.
Both batteries will be wired in parallel and connected by a megafuse. Then there is a master switch and the power is fed to a positive bus bar under the main equipment area. Within the battery box is the shunt, and the old Victron BMV 501 within the switch panel has been replaced by the BMV 712 smart battery monitor. Within the cupboard, the MultiPlus has been installed into the boat's 230 volt system and connected to the main positive battery and negative bus bars. Engines on sailing boats of this size tend to be relatively small and so have small alternators. After discussing how you can damage an alternator in our previous video, Chris is installing a 50 amp buck boost between the alternator and the lithium system to regulate the power received. A 15 amp blue smart charger is powered from the MultiPlus and is set to a lead acid algorithm to charge both the engine starter and bow thruster batteries. The boat will have solar on board, so a smart solar charger controller MPPT 7515 has been installed. The BMS is also within this area and wired to the batteries. A 65 amp smart battery protect from the solar, as well as the buck boost, are connected to the overvoltage alarm cable within the BMS. A larger 220 amp smart battery protect that supplies the boat's 12 volt appliances has been connected to the undervoltage alarm cable within the BMS. In the description below is a link to a blog that accompanies this video, as well as a link to the post within the Victron community, where you can ask more questions and see the schematic drawing used by UK Marine Electronics Limited for this install.
We hear the argument about using your phone and your iPad not only for looking at the Victron, but for navigating in general. The problem is when you're outside there and the weather turns really bad, the first thing it's going to pack up is your iPad or your iPhone. The Raymarine equipment and navigation equipment in general is marinized. It's very, very rugged. If you throw a bucket of water at it, it's going to keep working. At the end of the day, without any power at sea, the next call is going to be to the lifeboat. So you need to know how your power systems are doing. You need to know how much power you've got available. Maybe a motorboat, it's not quite as important, but certainly a yacht on a long passage is going to want to know exactly how much power he's got available. I think he's going to be pretty impressed with this system. He's used to the batteries fading away on the thing. He's used to the old instruments not being quite right. This is an ultra-modern system. It's going to work really, really well for him.